Hello students, myself Ayushi Tank. I welcome you on Invira Online School. Today we will start our first chapter for class 4th. So name of our first chapter is Roman numerals. What is Roman numerals? In this chapter we learn about Roman numerals. So here we learn about 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9. These numbers are called Hindu Arabic numerals. Why these numbers called Hindu Arabic numerals? Because first of all, Hindus are used these number, and then Arabians are used these numbers. So these numbers are called Hindu Arabic number. But the Romans used these symbols to return these number. Which are these symbols? English alphabets for write the numbers. For write the 1, they use I. 5, they use V. 10, X. 50, L. 100, C. 500, D. And 1000, M. They used these symbols to write the numerals. Now, how can they write the remain numbers? Like, if they want to write 2, so how can they write number 2? So let's learn about this. For remains number, they use the pattern of repeating. So how can repeating? So there are 1. 1 is I. Now if we write 2, so let's repeat this I. 1 and 2. This is how can they use to write 2. Then 3. So this is 3. 3 times I. Then 4. So I V. This is called 4. Then 5. 5 is V. So this is V. Then 6. So V. V means 5 and 1. I means 1. So this is 5, 1, 6. Then 7. 5, 2, 7. Then 8. 5, 3, 8, and then 9. So this is 9, I and X. Then 10, so here is 10. Next, if I will want to write 11, so X, 10, and 1 is 11. So this is how can they write the numbers, the repeating pattern. So now we learn about some rules to write the Roman numerals. Let's learn some rules, basic rules to form Roman numerals. Let's start. Rule number first is repeating means addition. Repeating means addition. So for example, let's take I. So what is mean of this I? 1, and it's repeated. Repeated 2 times. So here repeating means addition. So 1 plus 1 is equal to 2. So repeating means addition. So this is 2. And 1, 2, 3. This I is repeated 3 times. So 1 plus 1 plus 1 is equal to 3. So repeating means addition. Just like this. X means 10. So here is 2x. So 10 plus 10 is equal to 20. So this means 20. And if the x repeated 3 times, so 10 plus 10 plus 10 is equal to 30. So here repeating means addition. The first rule to form a Roman numerals is repeating means addition. So here we have a note that I, X, C and M repeated almost 3 times. These numerals repeated only 3 times, but V, L, D cannot repeat it. So here the first rule is repeated means addition. So here I, X, C and M repeated only 3 times. 1 time, 2 time and only 3 times, not 4 times. And but V, L, D cannot repeat it. These symbols cannot be repeated. Okay, let's go to our next rule, rule number 2. So here is smaller number return to the right to a larger number is always add. So let's see an example. So if a smaller number return to right to a larger number, if this is V means 5 and I means 1. So this is a bigger number and this is a smaller number. If the smaller numbers return to the right side, so it means add. So this is 5 plus 1 is equal to 6. So this is a symbol used to write 6. One more example. X means 10. And if I write I to the right of X, I means 1. So X means 10. 10 is a bigger number. And I means 1, which is a smaller number. So this is add. So X means 10 plus 1 is equal to 11. This is called 11. This symbol is used to write 11. So take one more example, which is L X is equal to, L means 50 and X means 10. So here is L means 50, which is a larger number, and X is 10, which is a smaller number. So let's add 50 plus 10 is equal to 60. So if we write the smaller number to the right of larger number, so always be add. Let's go to our next rule, rule number 3. Smaller number returned to the left to a larger number is always subtract. Let's understand this with an example. What is this? I means 1 and V means 5. So 5 and 1. So 1 is the left side to the bigger number. So let's subtract from bigger number. So bigger number is 5 minus 1 is equal to 4. So this symbol is used to write number 4. One more example. I means 1 and x means 10. Here also the smaller number is to the left side to a larger number. So x means 10 minus 1 is equal to 9. So this symbol is used to write number 9. Next, x and l. So l is a bigger number. L means 50 and x means 10. So here 50 minus 10 is equal to 40. So this symbol is used to write 40. Let's go to our next rule. Rule number 4. A smaller numeral between two greater numbers get subtracted from the numeral on its right. So let's understand this with an example. So if I take an example that x, I, v. So x means 10, I means 1, so 10, 1, and v means 5. So a smaller number. So when is a smaller number? Is between two greater numbers. So 10 and 5 is greater than 1. So gets subtracted from to the numerals its right. So x means x plus I v. Okay. So here is x and IV. IV means if the smaller number is to the left of a bigger number. So what we are doing? Subtract. So x plus v minus I. So here is x means 10 plus 5 minus 1. So 10 plus 5 is 15 and 15 minus 1 is 14. So this symbol is used to write 14. So here is subtracted from the numerals its right. So the numeral it right is 5. So 1 is get subtract from 5. Let's take one more example. X means 10. I means 1 and x. So here is x plus ix. X means 10 plus ix means x means 10 and minus 1. So it subtract from the numeral its right. So x minus 1. So 10 minus 1. So 10 plus 10. 10 plus 10 is 20. And 20 minus 1. 20 minus 1 is 19. So if we want to write 19 in Roman, we used this symbol. Let's take one more example. X. I, x. So here is xx repeating. So x means 10 plus 10. Then ix, this I is subtract from the numeral its right. So this x means 10 minus 1 is equal to. So 10 plus 10, 20. 20 plus 10, 30. And 30 minus 1 is 29. So this is 29. So we write 29, we use this symbol. Now look at the board. You find a Roman numeral chart. So many numbers in Roman symbols. Let's look at the board. Now look at the board. So here we write the Hindu Arabic numerals and here we write the Devanagari numerals. So this is we learned in our previous class. So let's revise it. So in Hindu Arabic, first number we write is 0. And in Devanagari, the 0 is just like same. Next number is 1. So how can we write 1? In Devanagari, 1 we write like this. This is 1. Then 2 in Hindu Arabic, and this is 2 in Devanagari. This is 3 in Hindu Arabic, and this is 3 in Devanagari. This is 4 in Hindu Arabic, and this is 4 in Devanagari. This is 5 in Hindu Arabic, and this is 4 in Devanagari. This is 6 in Hindu Arabic, and here this is 6 in Devanagari. Next, 7. So this is 7. 8. This is 8. Then 9. So here is 9. So here we write the Devanagari numerals. So just like the Hindu Arabic, if we write 11, so 1 and 1. Just like this, in Devanagari, we write 1 and 1. This is called 11. If we write 2 and 9, this is 29. So how can we write 29 in Devanagari? So 2 and 9. This is Devanagari. So here we learn about Devanagari numerals. So here this part is completed. So what we learn in this part? We learn about Roman numerals and also we learn about Devanagari numerals. So for our practice, we are doing some exercise in our next part. So do practice for this at your home. Thank you.